This week, many Americans were introduced to Paula White, the pastor and faith advisor to Donald Trump. Faith is something that he swears is really important to him. So the person who's advising him on that, very important. In case you have not seen some of her work, here's a little bit.
To say no to President Trump would be saying no to God. And I won't do that.
We are in a spiritual war right now. Let every demonic network that has aligned itself against the purpose, against the calling of President Trump, let it be broken. Let it be torn down in the name of Jesus.
You want me to tell you what my thoughts are? The thoughts of the King of Kings, the thoughts of the Lord of Lords. I'm downloading heaven. Hey!
There's a Department of Treasury in heaven that God is watching over everything you do, and you are storing up eternal treasure that will go so far beyond, I think, that we can even begin to imagine. You need to send in $3,500. You need to send in $35,000. You need to send in that $100,000 check. If you do not write that P.O. box and you do not call that toll-free number and you do not become a ministry of sustainer, you will never see sustainment in your life, and your dream will die, your call will die.
That was threatening for a religious message there. So that last little bit, we're gonna return to that, the requests for money. But there was some other stuff in that video. JR, what do you think about his faith advisor?
This is the perfect faith advisor for this president, who this is the kind of faith he's got. It's fake, it's seeking money, it's using people that are in a different position that will praise you in order to get that money. So it's perfect. It sets up perfectly. We've seen him go to Liberty University and quote 2 Corinthians. We've seen him get asked about his favorite Bible verse, and he says the whole damn thing.
All of them.
And which one? Old or New Testament? The semi-New Testament? So if he knows nothing about faith or religion or Christianity or any of that stuff. In fact, he despises it. So does she, except she found a way to use it to make money the way he did. So this is a perfect marriage.
Yeah, and look, we had another video. We don't have time to play it, but it was a whole bunch of an earlier thing where she's talking to her audience and saying, if you want to succeed in life, you need to sacrifice by giving me money. You need to give me $100, you need to give me $1,000. I don't care how hard you're struggling, I don't care what your problems are. Whatever money you have, give that to me. Whatever money you don't have, get some money, then give that money to me. I'm not 21 anymore. I don't want to offend religious people just for the fun of it. But she's a fake, doubt she even believes in God. Yeah. She's in it for the money. And there's a ton of people that are like that, the prosperity gospel people. They're frauds, and it is a shame that so many people get hoodwinked by them. Reverend William J. Barber, a religious leader who I have a lot of respect for, said, it's an attempt to interpret the gospel to be primarily about personal wealth and personal power, which is contrary to the theology of Jesus, where the good news was always focused on caring for the poor, the least of these, the stranger, the sick. She can't do that because she's too busy buying multi-million dollar mansions and planes for herself.
Yeah, and because, you know, the poor, the least, the stranger, and the sick can't give her money to help enrich her. So who cares about them? They're done.
Yeah. Yeah. And also, you know, I don't want to offend people, but speaking in tongues is not a thing. I mean, you like at that point, come on, wake up. What are you listening to? I know it's a thing, and I know she ran a Pentecostal church. It's a thing that's done by certain sects of Christianity, but like, if all of the rest of that doesn't clue you into the con that she's running, at that point, it certainly should. Thank you for watching this clip from the Damage Report. For more content from the show and access to TYT Network members-only exclusives, go to tyt.com/Brooke. Wait, no, it's tyt.com/John. Go to tyt.com/John to sign up.